Hello, welcome to this episode of The Classics. Today I will be talking about the série de Bertrand, or Bertrand series. So we're going to mess around with this object here. This a sum of the 1 over n to the power alpha times natural logarithm to the power beta of n. So at first we'll look at the case where beta equal 1, where alpha equal 1, and then we'll generalize for different value of alpha. So let's see that. So scrolling down, number 9. Okay, série de Bertrand. So I call u of n the sequence 1 over n times ln to the power beta of n. If beta is negative or 0, then we have this inequality here. That is fairly logic due to the properties of the natural logarithm. So this harmonic series diverges by comparison to a Riemann series, so the series of the 1 over n. So the series of un diverges. If beta is superior to 0, then we have this thingy that is actually defined, decreasing because of 1 over xln to the power beta of x, continuous and positive. So far is cool. Also the interval is 2 plus infinite because else this is actually negative. So we'll take the case where some integer k, and since f is decreasing, we have this inequality. So basically, you put inequality based on the integral. That's I don't know how that's called in English, but it's encadrement par des intégrales, so like cornering the function f of k by two integrals in an inequality. So you get this inequality by the works on integrals. Then you will sum this inequality with k in range 3 to n. So you will get this. And you will add f of 2 in both sides, because that will be fairly useful. So we'll take the case where beta equal 1 and make the substitution u equal n of x. So this integral becomes this, and by replacing we get this. So the partial sum diverges because in plus infinity this diverges, because ln of something to the infinity is infinity, of course. If beta is inferior to 1, then we get this, and this diverges too, since this goes to infinity. If beta is superior to 1, we get this thingy here, and it actually converges to this thingy, so that's pretty cool. It's the same method that we used, but we get different results due to the power. So this converges if beta is superior to 1, so it's cool. Now we'll take the example of un, so not alpha equal 1, but in all cases. If alpha is superior to 1, we call gamma to be equal to 1 plus alpha plus over 2. That is superior to 1. Then we replace it on n to the power of gamma un. We replace, and actually this converges to 0 due to comparison, and so it converges. So that's it. If alpha equal 1, we get the same thing as the last question, so it depends on b. And if alpha is inferior to 1, if we do that, we get something inferior to 1. And when we do n to the power of gamma un, it diverges by comparing to a Riemann series, because the exponent of n is inferior to 1, and by the work of Riemann, it diverges. Okay, so that's it for this exercise. It was a fairly short one, but the Bertrand series are very used in the math world. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. And bye.